Hey guys, what is going on and welcome to my channel. So for today I will be doing a lip swatch of all the 8 shades of the Wet n Wild Megalast Liquid Catswizzle. Hey guys, what is going on and welcome to my channel. So for today I will be doing a lip swatch of all the 8 shades of the Wet n Wild Megalast Liquid Catsuit Matte Lipstick. I hope I'm right. It's a mouthful. So I got all the 8 shades and I will be doing a lip swatch. I had already owned about 4 of them. That is the Coral Corruption, the Give Me Mocha, the what is the other one called? Missy and Fierce, as well as the Berry Recognized. Yeah, these are the 4 shades that I had already. I picked up the rest of the 4 of them and I wanted to see how they look so that I can do this video for you guys. So these catsuit, we're just gonna call it as Wet n Wild catsuit, whatever, okay? So these liquid lipsticks from Wet n Wild catsuit collection, they are priced at $4.99 in India. I picked mine out. A few of them I got from Nykaa, a few from hokmakeup.com. They are available on Amazon as well. So these are the products that are readily available in India. So these Wet n Wild lipsticks are vegan, cruelty-free, as well as their expiry is about 18 months. So before we can jump into the video, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. This is such a cool tone shade. Surprisingly, I like it. I usually don't, but not so bad. Okay, let me quickly discuss about the pros and cons of this lipstick. For the pros, it is available all over India, that is not on retail store. I have never seen Wet n Wild in a retail store, but it is available on Nykaa, on hkmakeup.com, as well as on Amazon as well. The second pro is going to be that it is priced at 499 Indian rupees. And the last pro is going to be it is very moussey. It feels comfortable on the lips. It's not too drying. And even when it fades in a graceful manner, not too patchy. But I really do enjoy these shades over here. And Give Me Mocha is the shade that I wear almost every other day for office. It's a perfect everyday kind of a lipstick, not too dark or bright, or not too, it's a very subtle, neutral, brownie, pinkish nude. If that makes sense. So that's one of my most favorite. Even formula wise, I feel that that's much more better. Now jumping into the cons, I feel that the formula is very inconsistent. It was really weird and I had a huge struggle with the lip shade that I'm wearing right now. This is the third time I'm wearing this and that's when I kind of got it kind of okay. Even though all the shades are moussey, but the Give Me Mocha one is a bit more better on application compared to the other shades. So yeah, and opaque wise, there are some shades that are really opaque and beautiful, but some of them I had a huge trouble was with, this was the worst by far, that is the nudist peach when it comes to application and the patchiness. The second worst I felt was the Flame of the Game. It's a beautiful orangey red, but it was just too patchy. It was, since it was very moussey, dried really fast. And that streaky patchiness was still there. And the last shade that I was struggling with is the Coral Corruption. So I feel that these three shades are kind of patchy, but if you like it, buy it and see. And if you know you're on the fence, then probably wait for a sale. If the price is lower, then pick it up. So this is my thought on these. The next con is going to be that these dry out really, really fast. I think the culprit for this is the texture, the moussey kind of a texture. I do like the texture, but at the same time, it is really drying. Like this is the older Give Me Mocha that I had. This is the new one that I picked out and this is the older one. And the older one, I think I worn it for work like for almost a month or two and it just dried out. Like for example, I have my other Holy Grail kind of lipsticks which I've worn for almost a year and a half and it's still there. It still exists. I still wear it every day, almost every other day, and it is still living and breathing, wherein this one is just gone. It's just dead and dried. So that's just the other thing, is that it dries out really fast. That's the con. And the last con, if I'm very nitpicky about it, I mean for the price it's amazing, but the last con is going to be on the applicator. So like I said before, I have worn Give Me Mocha numerous times, but because of the moussey texture of it, I think the Doe Fur applicator was not having it, because as you guys can see, it's really worn out. It's really, really worn out. I don't know. If you have already used this, then I think you would have experienced a similar one kind. So the applicator is kind of weird after a point of time. So that is the last con from me. So that is it for today's video, you guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Click on the like and comment down below if you have any questions. I will reply back to you. As well as do not forget to follow me on my socials, which is It's Nisha Nair on Instagram and It's Nisha Nair on Twitter as well. So until the next time, take care. Bye.